Bonjour, hi. Recently someone was asking me, hey, can GitHub Copilot or AI can help me converting an application? And I was like, yeah, of course, not only it will help you writing the code in that new language, but it will help your team collaborating, and it will help also people who know better the first language help working with that new language and the other way around with like other people. Because if you're converting, you're transitioning, and Copilot will be great to help you. So first, let me show you. So here I have code. So in my example, I will convert a COBOL application into Java. And I'm doing that because I don't know COBOL or Java. So I thought it was perfect. I really need Copilot to do that work. Obviously, in your case, like you have people who understand Copilot and you have people who understand Java. So now how you can do it. So as you can see here in my application, I didn't have anything running, so I am running in a dev container, and I use Copilot asking it to help me build that dev container. I also help ask Copilot, hey, what are the best extension to work in VS Code when I'm doing Java, and it guide me to build that environment. That took me just a few minutes, and now I have a proper environment where I know Java application should work. Great. So now, how do I do that? How do I start working? So in Copilot, right away, I could open Copilot, just like that, the chat, and you have different models. So you may be at ask, agent, and edit. Ask will be great for those questions when I was asking for like the best extension for Java. That was great. Edit will be great if I want to edit one simple document, but agent, this is what I want when I'm thinking about looking at different source, a file structure, looking the import, editing code for me, maybe creating new file for me. Agent will really do stuff on my behalf and take action. So in this specific case, I want an agent to help me. So then you have different model. Which model should you use? Well, preparing for this video, I did try different model, and they all worked. There was no there was difference in the structure and the code, but I think every time I will run that, even if I'm taking the same model, I will probably have different output. I really like Claude these days when I'm doing this kind of thing, because Claude is a little bit more verbose in what he's doing and kind of like keeping me part of those explanations. You will see as soon as I run. So right now I will take Claude Sonnet 3.5 and let's see how it works. So I want to give my instruction. So, okay, so here I'm asking it to convert this Hello Business COBOL application or program into Java. And I didn't have to specify it with the pound sign because the file is open, just to make sure I did it. So now I'll let it run and I'll get back to you just after. One thing also you could do is add a specific folder at the root of your project with in .github subfolder and have a file instruction in Markdown, and there put all your best practices, maybe the pattern, the tools, the version you want to use. Here, my project is very simple and I don't know Java. I'm assuming in your project, you will know the technology you're converting into. So you could write those so like the final project fit in your solution and follow the best practices that you decided to follow in your enterprise. Okay, so look like it's all done. So now I could see that even gave me the information that I need to like prepare and run it. I really like that. So I will definitely use that because I have no idea how to prepare for those kind of things. So let's just put this smaller. I can close now the COBOL version. I don't need it. And I will keep it, all the suggestions. That was great. One thing I would like is the report, because I want to compare the final report, I want the report to be in the report folder so I could have the old version and the new version and see if the output really match. So let's change that here. So we'll just add this. I could have asked also Copilot and like specifying, hey, you know what, like that new report, now I want it to create it in the report folder. That's a nice thing having AI is you could, as you're converting, you could add new feature that you want implemented. But my recommendation will be start first with the basic and then do by iteration. Okay, so let's give it a try. So it was those two. So it, one thing I really like, by the way, is it created two file. So I have my application and I have what looks like a kind of a employee, so like a class, clean class thing. And I didn't have that employee class in different tests that I did prior to record this video. So I'm kind of very happy about it. So now let's open the terminal. Let's run that command to compile. Great. Look like it did compile. So now I want to run the application. So apparently it's just Java Hello Business. Running that and boom, I have errors. Okay. So let's make it just a little bit smaller so I could. Okay, so it's really struggling with this. One thing that I know may cause problem is when we look at the data, where it is here, we can see that there's no line break. And if I select the first user, so it start by 001, and we can see that Alice record start by here 002. There's no break line, there's no nothing. So it's really kind of like a flat file format where just like it worked by length of information. So I can see that here it's 19 character for a record. So one thing I can do is go back here and specify. So let's start a new environment. Specify the error. I want it to look into the terminal, the output, and I will also specify that information about the 19 character. So I will highlight here the error message in terminal selection. So I provide more information, just like I said, and let's see how it works. Okay, it's done. And here it explained what it did. I can also see the modification. I really like that part. As I said, I am a spectator in that conversion, but I'm not just looking, I'm interacting. So I'm still having some participation to do. And here is okay, this will be removed, just like when you do a Git merge. And here, that's what I had and stuff like that. And look like it will be a little bit smarter about how it does. So let's keep all that and let's clean my terminal and let's rerun the command to compile and rerun the business, see if it works better. Okay, so now it definitely works. Let's close Copilot and look here at the output. We can see it ran, it took John, Alice, Bob, Mary, it saw all the users. So now let's have a look to the report. So we'll click here, the report is there. Let's minimize this here. So cool, I have a new report. It looks pretty good, but I feel like it's not exactly the same. So have a look to the previous message. I will double click here to make sure it's open. And let's open that previous version in a side by side. Okay, so it's very similar where I have like employee list, and that was written like by the code at the beginning. But then like now I see that in the new version, I don't have the buffer zero in front. I could definitely change that. I have the total salary. Maybe it's nice. Maybe it's a plus value that it's cool. And all recorder now, like there's no jump line here. I could see like there's a line in between. So I see the result. It's definitely getting better, but it's not perfect. So as you can see, Copilot can really help you navigate your conversion, speed it up, help you improve the collaboration between teammates who don't necessarily know the other language, but it's not perfect. You need to stay there and stay involved. in my case, the solution was very simple. So I did try to do like the entire program, but usually try to take smaller pieces, module, function, and stuff like that to make sure it's manageable. Taking thousands of lines and asking Copilot to change it, you may be lucky. I did experiment a few times doing that conversion, kind of like one shot it, and sometimes it works. Sometimes I had one file generated, sometimes, like you saw in this example, had two files generated. Sometimes it updates the make document, so I could just run make and make run. Sometimes it was letting me use JavaScript, Java come in with Java C to compile and stuff like that. Sometimes I didn't have any, so I asked Copilot, hey, how do I run a Java program? So Copilot definitely help you. The result will change. It's generative AI, so don't expect the same result all the time, but it's definitely a tool that you need to have, and it's worth using in a conversion project. So I hope this video helped you to understand how it could help and why you should use it. And if you have any question, leave it in the comment down below, and see you in the next one. Thank you.